This is a review of the Tenma 722660 single channel power supply. This is sold under other brands elsewhere, like Amazon, under Tech Power or MassTech. It's a small, portable 50 watt switching power supply with a single channel, constant voltage, and some current limiting. It's not much larger than a handheld voltmeter, and it has a stand that comes out of the back so you can stand it up. Plugging in the AC turns it on immediately. There's no actual on or off switch. It's probably the most annoying thing of this power supply. It immediately boots up and turns onto this display. Pressing the up button turns on the backlight, and you have to press down to turn the backlight off. And then the left and right buttons adjust the contrast of the display. The bottom right button turns on the output and turns it back off. It's not a power button. And the display shows the current voltage. If you hit the VA toggle, now the display shows the current amps. You have to hit the set button in the middle if you want to change the voltage or the current output. You can move one position at a time, one digit, and move them up and down. This can be done while the output is on or off. And of course, it's independent of the monitor on the bottom. You hit the VA to switch over to amps, and now you can edit the current limit. You'll notice there's USB ports on the bottom and a USB button. Pressing that button enables those two ports and immediately changes the voltage setting to 5.1 volts, 2.5 amps. There's also a save and recall button, and you have five memory positions. Here I have a 1 amp and 12 volt that I've just recalled quickly. And of course, you can click on the USB and jump back to 2.5. amps, 5 volts. And just to prove, I again recalled that one memory position. So I have it hooked up to a strong load here with this bulb to demonstrate the current limit. It's 2 volts, 3.75 amps is the highest current rating of the supply. The bulb takes a bit to warm up, but here you can see I'm changing the output as it's running. And I'm about to hit the current limit there. So in this case, it does limit the current. I found many times it just turns off the output. So it's not so great as a constant current supply. Works great for constant voltage, but sometimes you can get in the current limit and bring it back down. And you can see as I'm reducing the current, it does limit it, but it did at one point finally turn off the output. So now let's hook it up to a scope and look at the waveforms. I'm still hooked up to the bulb, so it just climbs slowly while it warms up and then reaches its voltage. It's a very clean output. There's not really any switching noise to be seen. If I turn it off and back on again, it should snap right to the full output this time. There you go. Now for a quick capture of the single turn on there, you see it ramps up slowly and then hits a current limit loop. If there's no limit, then it turns right on. So it's a nice smooth ramp, just a little bit of noise, and that's the current loop you're seeing at the end of that particular capture. Without current limit, you'll see it just a nice ramp up to full voltage there. Now just to demonstrate the USB output, you can plug something in USB and that turns right on, no problem. You monitor volts and amps. The nice thing in is you can adjust the current while in USB mode. You cannot adjust the voltage, but you can reduce the current if you'd like to. So overall, not bad. It's a very inexpensive, small and portable 50 watt supply. Great for constant voltage, nice smooth output. Have a look at the description for where to purchase this. Thanks for watching.